May it please the court. Your Honor, the court has only to look and give the merest glance at the plaintiff, Andrew Murga, to be able to consider the condition that he was left in by the illegal acts of the defendants, Mr. and Mrs. Morrow. What they did to him is injustice, but in a court of law, it speaks more of a crime. These medical reports that I hold in my hand indicate the following. His eyesight is impaired to the point of virtual blindness. The beating he received at the hands of the employees, and if I may say so, at the direction of the defendants, Mr. and Mrs. Morrow, resulted in nerve damage to the point where he will be a cripple for the rest of his life, walking with a cane, and he's a young man. That nerve damage was so bad that it causes him to stutter and to slur his words. He's incomprehensible in a conversation, and on top of that, he drools. He's the laughingstock of a community that previously respected him and even honored him for his good deeds, and he has sunk now to such a low estate. This cries out for redress in a court of law. The work environment is a work environment that caused these injuries, but this work environment was a work environment under the laws, as Your Honor knows, of today, where a person sues for an employment discrimination or other act in the employment place. That person has to demonstrate a hostile work environment, quote unquote. And this is what was created by the acts of Mr. and Mrs. Morrow, the defendants. But it wasn't just a hostile work environment, no, Your Honor. It was a living hell. These people decided to leave him in charge of their employees and required him to keep these employees for a period of 2 weeks on the premises, day and night, on the job, while they went on a vacation to Canada to have some fun, leaving this man in a situation that cried out for mutiny after a few days. The people working in an environment that was more like a prison, more like slavery, required by the defendants, eventually rebelled against Andrew. And it's that mutinous behavior and that rebellion that caused his injuries directly related to the acts of the defendants. And that's why we're here today in court. Now, Your Honor is going to ask me, what do I think should be done? Well, first of all, I think you have to take into account not only the hostile work environment, but the kind of people these people are to permit this kind of conduct that resulted in such grievous injuries and permanent injuries to the plaintiff, Andrew Murga. Who are these people? Who are these people, the Morrows? What gives them the right to dictate the terms of employment in such a way? They pay the barest minimum that the law requires as far as minimum wages. They give no benefits, no health benefits. There are no bonuses. These people that work for them work in abject slavery, and they put him in as the slave master. Not a very happy job to have. It's no wonder that they rebelled and turned against him. There is probably some justification somewhere for the acts that they did that caused this horrible grievance. But whatever the cause is, it lies outside the venue of this court. This court, and you ask me, you haven't asked me, but I'm sure that you're wondering what I think should be done. This can only be redressed by an award of money damages, an award that will give Andrew back his life, but also an award that will punish these two scoundrels, the Morrows. The Morrows, who have brought us such sorrows. Thank you, Your Honor.
Your Honor, we just cannot argue with the counsel's statements. So on that note, the defense rests.
What?
What the hell do you mean the defense rests?
Well, in
In that case, I find the defendants guilty on all charges. And I award Mr. Murga all the compensations that he requested, which are the following. The titles to all of your cars, the deed to your house, the full ownership and said business one, moving time video, case closed.
No!
No!
You can't do that!
Logan, you're fired. Your Honor, we demand a new attorney and a new trial.
This is an outrage. You're not even a real judge. I demand a mistrial.
Sorry, miss. You're going to have to file an appeal just like everybody else. Why don't you try appealing to the Supreme Court or something? I mean, I doubt it they'll be sympathetic for your cause. Now, if you'll excuse me.
All rise for the Honorable Judge Hector Rodriguez Sanchez Gomez Vasquez.
Judge Joe Brown starts in 5 minutes.
This is ridiculous.
More like ironic. Because now, after 5 long years, your ass works for me. Home at last.
So I got my level 75 red mage today. It's pretty cool. I'm like the only one in the world who has it. It is pretty cool.
Alas, my son! We meet again!
Better get comfortable in your new room. You're gonna be staying here until you pay off the rest of your debt. Not as bad as it sounds. Stay in your room until dinner. There you are! Get back to work! But you can stay here, on the top floor, where kings were meant to be. And together, we shall rule this day!